Crack this one open.
There you go. I found some money. Want it? Need money?
Looking for.
There it is.
It's your mother's grave.
They have her preserved in an airtight chamber. Her fingerprints will get us into Comstock House.
She's your mother.
A mother who abandons their child doesn't draw a lot of sympathy in my book.
Take a moment to think about what you're doing.
There. You open the door, or do I have to go in without you?
Elizabeth.
It's her. How are you, Mother? Locked up in there, huh? Looks like you and I have some common ground.
Let me do it.
No.
Let me do it.
You see, child? You chose to follow a false shepherd, and he has led you astray.
Where did she go?
Hold on, you need to rest for a minute.
No, I'm getting that hand.
Elizabeth, why is your mother a ghost?
She's not. He used me to power that device. He opened up some kind of tear.
Mother, raising the dead.
Shit!
You bet!
What is she? Alive or dead?
Why do you ask what?
When the delicious question is when.
The only difference between past and present
is semantics.
Lives, lived, will live.
Dies, died, will die.
If we could perceive time as it truly was.
What reason would grammar professors have to get out of bed?
Like us all, Lady Comstock exists across time.
She's both alive and dead.
She perceives being both.
She finds this condition disagreeable.
Perception without comprehension
is a dangerous combination.
Look!
Footsteps. She goes to unfinished business.
We have to follow her. Convince her to open the gate to Comstock House.
It's a shame you have need of her to enter Comstock House.
Frankly, she doesn't seem all that cooperative.
There is a way to bring her to reason.
Three truths you must discover first.
Truths which, in this world, Comstock has destroyed.
If only one of you had the power to alter time and space.
That would be a blessing, wouldn't it?
Well, they're sarcastic.
There's something off about Lady Comstock.
Yeah, I noticed.
No, you don't understand. She doesn't belong here. I brought something through. I'm not so sure it was her.
Some help with this.
Sure thing. It's done.
What the doctor ordered.
Booker.
Comstock has sabotaged our contraption.
Yet, we are not dead. A theory. We are scattered amongst the possibility space. But my brother and I are together, and so I'm content. He is not. The business with the girl lies unresolved. But perhaps there is one who can finish it in our stead.
It's a tear.
There's something in there. Should I open it?
Comstock seems to have been made sterile by simple exposure to our contraption. A theory. Just as sexual reproduction can de-emphasize the traits of each parent, so goes the effect of multiple realities on our own. Your traits dissipate until they become unrecognizable or cease to exist.
You are!
That's my mother.
I assure you, madam, my sexual interest in your dear prophet is non-existent.
Madam Mortas.
Furthermore, the man is quite sterile.
It's a lie. Come here, you little bastard! I want you out of my house!
Sterile? Then what were you to them?
She loved him. She decided to impress him. She deserved whatever Comstock did to her.
What did you mean before when you said Lady Comstock didn't belong here?
She's almost feral. It's like she's a reflection of... I don't know.
But I think she found that less believable than her delusion. Lady Comstock seems to believe the child is a result of some errant act of carnality between myself and her beloved prophet. I told the poor woman the truth, that the child was a product of our little contraption, but I think she found that less believable than her delusion.
Elizabeth!
There you go.
No mercy for us!
Open it.
On it!
Perfect timing. Do it!
Done.
Elizabeth?
That's it!
That'll do.
Here, ammo!
Go ahead!
There!
Now!
On it!
Take a look at this lock.
down!
Get up in the open!
Pick it up! Bring him out!
What's that?
50% of everything people earn here goes right to Comstock as a tithe.
I gotta get me a job in the profit business. Can you open this, Elizabeth?
Let me have a look. It's done.
Steps seem to go down to the vault.
Look, there's a cipher written on the stationery.
Hudson's Tailors.
Maybe that's where the code book is.
More money.
Can you open this?
On it. There you go.
Sabotage all their patents?
All of them, Mr. Fink.
Now, why does the Prophet want these two killed?
For the same reason Lady Comstock lies buried. Child.
And why does he want me to do it?
Because only you can make it seem an accident.
I don't think that's the real Lady Comstock. I think she's a combination of herself and my feelings towards her.
What do you mean?
I'm just so angry at her and at my father. I think she's her, but she's also partly me. I'm not even sure I understand it myself.
Yeah!